Good evening, ma'am. I'm Shravani from Final MZC. Today I want to explain about the topic granulocytes. Granulocytes are white blood cells that play a major role in the immune system to fight against the infection. And they have a characteristic morphology, having a large cytoplasmic granules, and they can be stained with basic dyes and containing a bilobed nucleus. Typically, granulocytes have a role both in innate and acquired immunity responses in the fight against the pathogens. As a part of immune responses, granulocytes migrate to the site of infection and release a number of different effector cells, including histamine, chemokines, and enzymes and growth factors. There are four types of neutrophils that are divided into basophils, neutrophils, eosinophils, and mast cells. Basophils. Only 1% of basophils present in the blood, and it has an irregular shape of bilobed nucleus, and basophils can be stained with basic dyes. After staining, the granules appear in the blue color, and basophils do not contain phagocytosis. Inflammation takes place in the basophils only. Eosinophils. Here 3-5% of the eosinophils are present in the blood, and acidic stains are used, and granules are present in the red color. These participate in the defense mechanism, and these secrete cationic proteins and toxic substances. Neutrophils, polymorphonuclear cells. Neutrophils are the polymorphonuclear cells, and 60% of the neutrophils present in the blood, and the high amount is neutrophils only, and these are called as army of the blood and scavengers of the blood. And two types of neutrophils are present here. They are primary and secondary. And the neutrophils can be two types again. They are oxygen independent and oxygen dependent. The example under primary are lysozyme pyridoxine. And the example under secondary neutrophils are lysozyme and lactoferrin. And high count of granulocytes present in the blood results to the granulocytosis. And low count of granulocytes present, they are called as granulocytogenesis. It indicates the infection and autoimmune responses are dead cell cancers. Thank you, ma'am.